about when he walked into that room with those young people on Friday night. One thing I can say about a number of those young people is that they'll never be the same. Because what before was unknown is now known. What before was just theory is now a fact and is practiced. And I think God wants to reveal himself like that to all of us. I think God wants to reveal his mighty power to us. He wants to walk into our funeral and reach in the coffin and raise what has died in us. He wants to walk into our temples, and when he does, believe me, he's going to start flipping over tables, and he's going to make a whip, and he's going to drive out all of the sheep and the goats, and he's going to drive out the cattle. But the question is, will you allow him entrance? Will you even let him in the temple? And as I say, some people, they would rather not let him in because they're happy how they are. And that's your choice, and he loves you so much that he gives you free choice to decide. But I say tonight, let's let the King of Glory come in. Let's let the King of Glory come into our life and reach into our life. You might be like the widow of Nain, and there's a situation in your life that's like your son has died and you need a miracle. I'm telling you, we serve an awesome God that is capable of doing that miracle and can raise whatever has died in your life. You may be like those in the temple, and your temple might be full of things, and you have habits, you have little things in your life that you can't seem to get free of, and they're plaguing you, and they're disrupting what the original purpose of the temple was all about. And you need his holy power to come into you and drive that out. I'm telling you, he can do that for you tonight. There's nothing impossible for our God. You may have confusing questions about doctrines and ideas and about what's right and what's not right and should we pay taxes, and Jesus can bring an answer to you to give you the peace that you need in your heart in every situation. If we listen to his words, if we follow him, if we yield to him, nothing is impossible. You are Lord, my God. What is the sin of song? As we do, we're going to worship, and I want you to just contemplate whatever your situation is, whatever you need the Lord for you to do tonight. As we sing, Lord of all, just yield to the Lord. Let him in that temple. Let him come on the scene, and it's going to challenge you, but I'm telling you, my advice is that you get free and not get offended. Don't resist the Spirit of the Lord. Don't resist the Spirit of the Lord. Sing with me, Lord of all, Lord of all.
I give all myself.
I give.